Turning to the election campaign now, and Labor is promising a faster move to 100% renewable energy. But National says that'll push up energy prices. Political parties were in full campaign mode up and down the country today. And staying across it, of course, One News political editor Jessica Mutch-Mackay.
From cafe catch-ups in Palmerston North.
Hello, Theo. Yeah. Oh, what a lovely boy.
I'm doing great.
Wait, am I lined up? Does it look real?
To playing tourist in Taupō. A run-in in Rangiora.
You're not keeping Cindy honest.
Yes, look, your job's keeping her honest, not mine.
Not mine. It's not your job, your deputy.
My job's keeping me honest.
No. No, sorry.
Nah, mate. You go and vote for those weirdos.
And in the swing of campaigning in the capital. Jacinda Ardern using a visit to a power station to announce if re-elected, Labor would make New Zealand 100% reliable on renewable energy by 2030, 5 years earlier than planned.
Today's policy is a really exciting part of our plan to make sure that New Zealand is transitioning its economy for the future.
We're already at 84%, and the idea is to fast-track projects like at Lake Onslow, where a battery is being developed to store hydropower. Labor says it can do this without pushing up electricity prices. But the alarm bells are ringing for the former energy minister.
The Labor Party really needs to front up and tell Kiwis just how much it's going to cost them in increased electricity prices. It's something that we've looked at in the past in terms of what we could do, and what we know is it would put up a huge cost to electricity users.
What you've got here is dreamtime stuff. We're going to do it all by 2030. It hasn't got a hope in Hades of working.
The Opportunities Party pitching an idea of its own, a 20% tax on junk food, including sugary drinks, it says will raise $1 billion.
With that money, we will make sure that we can keep GP visits to under $10 and provide free dental care to 20% of Kiwis.
The crisscrossing of the country continues, with parties using policies and billboards and walkabouts to try and get attention and win over voters. The clock is ticking with 5 weeks to go.
There's some lessons for fresh candidates.
William, get in the photo.
Of course, sorry, Judith. She is the boss for a reason.
Parties using different tactics.
Where do you want this?
Watch out for politicians coming to a town near you. Jessica Mutch-Mackay, One News.